Hi guys, my name is Jamil Ahmed, and as you know that we were discussing about the third chapter of the biochemistry, and it's about transcription. And you know that in transcription the enzyme used RNA polymerase. So RNA polymerase is an enzyme which is used to let's suppose that this is the DNA double strand. Then DNA double strand, one strand is the template strand and one strand is the codex strand. So this RNA polymerase will come and it will read the template strand, because template strand will be transcribed, this one will be transcribed and this one will not be transcribed. Codex strand will not be transcribed, template strand will be transcribed. So this RNA polymerase will come and it comes here and it forms the RNA using the DNA as a template. So it uses the DNA template strands, reads the DNA template strands and form the RNA. This is the function of RNA polymerase. But you know that RNA polymerase, there is no, in this lecture we will discuss about the comparison of RNA polymerase in prokaryotes and eukaryotes. That what is the comparison of prokaryotic polymerase, prokaryotic RNA polymerase and eukaryotic RNA polymerase. So we will discuss about little bit about that comparison, just very small topic. Four points. The first one says that the single RNA polymerase, that is alpha 2 beta beta prime, is used. Single RNA polymerase, that named as the alpha 2 beta beta prime. Why this is named so? Because this single RNA polymerase consists of the four proteins, so it is a tetramer. Mean that consists of the four proteins. These tetramer are four proteins will combine with each other and they will form the complex and that complex named as the RNA polymerase, prokaryotic RNA polymerase. RNA polymerase alpha 2 beta beta prime. So alpha, this RNA polymerase is a tetramer of four proteins that combines with each other and forms the complex that named as the RNA polymerase alpha 2 beta beta prime. And in prokaryotes, this RNA polymerase is single, and this single RNA polymerase is responsible for the production of different types of RNA. Mean that what is the function of RNA polymerase? Production of RNA, but there are different types of RNA. Maybe the transfer RNA, maybe the ribosomal RNA, messenger RNA, heterogeneous nuclear RNA, smaller nuclear RNA, mean that all types of the RNA will be produced by this, RNA polymerase alpha 2 beta beta prime. So RNA polymerase alpha 2 beta beta prime in prokaryotes is responsible for the production of all types of RNA. But if we discuss the same concept in eukaryotes, then in eukaryotes there are the different three RNA polymerase. RNA polymerase 1, RNA polymerase 2 and RNA polymerase 3. The RNA polymerase 1 is used for the production of the most abundant type of RNA, that is ribosomal RNA. So RNA polymerase 1 is responsible for the production of ribosomal RNA, and remember that it is present in the nucleolus. That's important, that RNA polymerase 1 is present in the nucleolus, and that's very important MCQs. That RNA polymerase 1 is present in the nucleolus and it is responsible for the production of ribosomal RNA, except 5S ribosomal RNA. What is this concept? As you know that ribosomal RNA has two subunits. One is the small subunit and one is the large subunit. Okay, large unit and small unit. And further, the small unit and large unit have smaller subunits. Let's suppose that ribosomal RNA has 28S, 18S, 5.8S and 5S. These are the subunits of ribosomal RNA. Ribosomal RNA have four subunits, 28S, 18S, 5.8S, 5S. So out of these 5S, these three, these three subunits, 28S, 18S and 5.8S, are produced by the RNA polymerase? One. But one single subunit, that is the 5S, it is not produced by the RNA polymerase 1. Rather, it is produced by the RNA polymerase 3. Okay, so this is the concept that RNA polymerase 1 is present in the nucleolus and it is responsible for production of ribosomal RNA subunits 28S, 18S and 5.8S. Except 5S ribosomal RNA. 5S ribosomal RNA is produced by the RNA polymerase type 3. That's important. And another thing you can remember that this is the subunit of larger. This is the larger subunit. And this is the smaller subunit. This is the larger subunit. And this is also the larger subunit. So one only one, that is 80S. 18S is the small subunit. Subunit of small unit of the ribosomal RNA. The next is the RNA polymerase 2. The RNA polymerase 2 is responsible for the production of heterogeneous nuclear RNA. Heterogeneous nuclear RNA or the messenger RNA. Both will be produced. As you know that messenger RNA is produced by the first heterogeneous nuclear RNA will be produced. Then heterogeneous on heterogeneous nuclear RNA, because heterogeneous nuclear RNA, you know that heterogeneous nuclear RNA is the pre-messenger RNA. This is the pre-messenger RNA. Then RNA polymerase will produce the some small nuclear RNA. Then some small nuclear RNA will come. Then it will cause its splicing. Splicing means that it will cause the removal of introns. And when introns will be removed, then this premature messenger RNA will be changed into messenger RNA. We have explained this in the previous lecture. That what is this? This says that RNA polymerase 2 will produce the heterogeneous RNA. Heterogeneous RNA also named as the pre-messenger RNA. Then it will produce the also small nuclear RNA. Then small nuclear RNA will cause the splicing of pre-messenger RNA or heterogeneous nuclear RNA. So it will cause splicing. Splicing means removal of introns. So after the removal of introns, the exons will come and they will meet each other and they will form the messenger RNA. Okay, this is the concept. But for exams, you can remember that RNA polymerase 2 is responsible for the production of heterogeneous nuclear RNA, messenger RNA, or some amount of the small nuclear RNA. Okay. The third is the RNA polymerase 3, that is responsible for the transfer RNA, and 5S ribosomal RNA, that is this one, okay, this concept behind that. The second point is this, that if this is a template strand, then RNA polymerase comes and here is a promoter, and after that here is a coding region, okay. In the previous lecture, we have discussed is that this RNA polymerase comes and it recognizes and binds to promoter and causes the transcription on the coding region. That's simple, okay? So it says that it requires a sigma to initiate at a promoter. It says that the first this sigma factor will come. And it will bind with the promoter. When it will bind with the promoter, now RNA polymerase will recognize that sigma factor is binded, sigma factor is bound to promoter. Then it will come and it will land on it. Otherwise, it will not land. If sigma factor is not attached to promoter, then RNA polymerase will not land. When RNA polymerase see that sigma factor is attached to promoter, then it comes and attached, it lands on the promoter and starts the transcription. And after the start of transcription, immediately this sigma factor will be released out. So this is the concept behind that. That it requires the sigma factor. Sigma factor will come. It will bind with the promoter. Then RNA polymerase will recognize this mechanism and it will come and bind with the promoter and will start the transcription. But this one says that in eukaryotes, there is a no sigma factor. In eukaryotes, no sigma factor. There is a, but some transcription factors. Example is the transcription TF2D. This is not II, this is 2D. You can say Roman 2, this is Roman 2, not II, this is Roman 2. And transcription factors 2D bind before RNA polymerase. Mean that transcription factors 2D will come and it will attach, it will bind with the promoter. And when RNA polymerase will see that TF2D is bounded to promoter, then it will come and it will bind to promoter and start the transcription. It's so simple. But there is a no sigma factor, remember that point. The third point is that sometime requires rho to terminate. As like that promoter, there are some terminators. After the transcription is complete, let's go, here is a terminator. Then RNA polymerase will see this terminator. Then it will terminate the transcription. So in prokaryotes requires rho terminators. So there will be the rho terminators. When there is a terminator, then now this polymerase has started the function of transcription. It is continuously transcripted, and when it will see the terminator, then it will terminate, it will stop the transcription. So it is behind that rho is needed in prokaryotes for transcription. But in eukaryotes, there is a no rho required. There is a no rho required for termination. Termination will happen by another way, but there is a no rho required. The next, that's very, very important, that's very important for clinically also and for exams also. That says that this prokaryotic RNA polymerase is inhibited by rifampin, and RNA polymerase 2 in eukaryotes is inhibited by alpha amanitin that is produced in mushrooms. And I'm going to explain it in detail. That first we are going to detail inhibited by rifampin. So rifampin inhibits this one. This one is the complex of 4 proteins. So rifampin will go and it will inhibit this one. When it will inhibit this one, then these RNA will be produced? No, because there is a no activated RNA polymerase. When no RNA polymerase, then no production of these. And then no production of these RNA, no production of these RNA, no production of proteins. No production of proteins, then the prokaryotes will dead. Prokaryotes will die. So the concept is this, that remember that rifampin is used for the treatment of which disease? TB. So it is used for the TB. So TB is because of the bacteria, and we will give the patient rifampin drug. Then rifampin drug will go and it will inhibit the single RNA polymerase of bacteria, that is the alpha 2 beta beta prime. So this will go and inhibit the RNA polymerase of bacteria. Then when this RNA polymerase will be inhibited, then there will be the no production of RNA. All RNA will not produce. When RNA will not produce, then there will be the no production of protein. Then there is the no production of proteins, then bacteria will die. When bacteria will die, then in this way we can cure the TB. And same this way, remember that rifampin is also used for meningitis. Rifampin is also used for the treatment of meningitis. But there is a one side effect of rifampin. Remember that? What is that? A bridge to pharmacology. The side effect of rifampin is the orange color urine, orange color tears, etc. Mean that after the treatment by rifampin, there will be the orange color tears, orange color urine of the patient. So I am going to repeat that rifampin is used for the treatment of TB, because TB is because of bacteria, because of prokaryotes. Then we will get the rifampin. Rifampin will block the RNA polymerase. When RNA polymerase will be blocked, will be inhibited, then there will be the no production of RNAs. When RNAs are not produced, then there will be no production of proteins. When proteins are not produced, then prokaryotes and bacteria will die, and in this way we can cure the TB. And rifampin is also used for the treatment of meningitis also. But there is a one side effect of rifampin. What is that? That is the orange color urine or tears after the treatment by the rifampin. And second, this prokaryotic transcription polymerase can be inhibited by the actinomycin D. Actinomycin D will go and it will bind with the DNA, and it will also prevent the transcription. Mean that if there is a DNA, then actinomycin drug will go and it will bind with the DNA, and it will stop the transcription and in this way. Transcription is actinomycin D is also used in this way. So now we will discuss about the eukaryotes. And eukaryotes has RNA polymerase. First we will discuss about actinomycin D. The actinomycin D is generally used to inhibit the all three types of RNA polymerase. If we give the actinomycin D, then actinomycin D will inhibit the RNA polymerase 1, RNA polymerase 2, and RNA polymerase 3. It is generally used to inhibit the all three types of RNA polymerase of eukaryotes. But if we talk about the RNA polymerase 2, especially, then it is inhibited by alpha amanitin. What is alpha amanitin? Alpha amanitin is the toxic which is produced by the mushrooms. It is produced by the mushrooms. So, if we eat the mushroom, then it causes the toxicity of liver. It destroys the liver. Liver will be destroyed. And it can destroy the liver too much that we need the transplant of liver. Mushrooms can destroy our liver too much that we need. Sometimes we need a transplant. Why? But why? Because when we eat the mushrooms, then mushrooms produce the alpha amanitin. It produces the alpha amanitin in liver. So it will produce the alpha amanitin. Alpha amanitin is the toxic. It will go and it will block the RNA polymerase 2. When RNA polymerase 2 will be blocked, then there will be the no production of messenger RNA. That's very important for the production of proteins. When there is a no messenger RNA production, then there is a no production of proteins. When there is a no production of proteins in our body, then it will destroy the liver. So liver will be destroyed and then we will need the liver transplant. So what is concerned that? If we eat the mushroom, then it can cause the liver destroy. But why? Because it produces the alpha amanitin, that is a toxic. This toxic will go and it will inhibit the RNA polymerase 2. When RNA polymerase 2 will be inhibited, then there will be no more production of messenger RNA. When messenger RNA will not produce, that is very important for the production of the proteins. When proteins will not produce, the liver will be destroyed and we will need the transplant. So it was about little bit comparison of RNA polymerases. RNA polymerases in prokaryotes and in eukaryotes. So thank you so much, guys. In next lecture, we will discuss about the transcriptions. So thank you so much.